Hello, girls and boys. This is lesson 26 of English for You. Mike and Dan have come to the GDR. Today, they are in Rostock. Mike has come here as a reporter, and Anne has come with him. Mike's newspaper has sent him to write some articles about the GDR. Articles about living and working conditions. Über die Lebens- und Arbeitsbedingungen. About living and working conditions. Mike wants to learn something. Er möchte etwas erfahren. He wants to learn something about the living and working conditions, about wages and prices, about the rents in the GDR. Here is a new building in Berlin. My friend has got a flat in this building. Mein Freund hat eine Wohnung in diesem Gebäude. His flat is in this new building. He pays 80 marks a month. That's not much. Every year, thousands of families get new flats. Thousands of families. Tausende Familien. Every year, thousands of families get new flats in the GDR. Mike and Dan also want to learn something about sports in the GDR. Über den Sport in der DDR. But they also want to have a look at some interesting sights. Sights. Sehenswürdigkeiten. Sights. They want to have a look at some interesting sights. Now say after me. A new building. A flat. $1,000. Interesting sights. Thank you. Mike and Dan are in Rostock. They've been there since Thursday. Let's have a look at these sentences. They are in Rostock. They have been there since Thursday. Im Deutschen verwenden wir in beiden Sätzen das Präsens. Sie sind in Rostock. Sie sind seit Donnerstag dort. Und in den englischen Sätzen? They are in Rostock. Present. They have been there since Thursday. Present perfect. Wenn wir angeben, seit wann ein Zustand schon andauert, since Thursday, verwenden wir das present perfect. They've been there since Thursday. They've been there for 2 days. Sie sind seit 2 Tagen dort. Das present perfect brauchen wir auch dann, wenn wir die bisherige Dauer des Zustandes angeben. For 2 days. They've been there for 2 days. Now let's see what Mike and Dan have learned in the last 2 days. Let's watch our film, A Visit to Rostock. Ein Besuch in Rostock. A Visit to Rostock. This is Rostock. Mike and Dan have only been here for 2 days, but they've seen a lot of interesting things already. They've had a look at many of the sights, at the beautiful old houses. Mike has taken a lot of photos. This is the Neptune Hotel where Mike and Anne have rooms.
Frau Schumann, what's the name of that building?
It's the Town Hall, das Rathaus. It's a beautiful old building.
Mike and Anne have had a look at the shop windows. They have been in shops. They have also visited some museums. Here they are on a ship. This ship is a museum now. It's the Shipbuilding Museum, das Schiffbaumuseum. The ship has been a museum since 1970. Thousands of people visit this museum every year. Mike and Anne have learned a lot there about shipbuilding in the GDR. Mike and Anne have also had a look at the Warnow-Werft. Frau Schumann has told them how many ships the Rostock workers built last year. Here they are in the port. This is the port of Rostock, der Rostocker Hafen. Lots of ships arrive here every week.
Mike, I can't read the name of that ship over there. Is it Russian?
Yes, it is Russian, but I can't read it. Frau Schumann?
Yes?
Can you read Russian?
Oh, yes, I can.
What's the name of that ship over there?
Mechanik Fyodorov.
Thank you.
Mike and Anne have not only seen a lot of interesting things, they've also learnt something about the people of Rostock. And they've talked to people from other towns. They have learnt that every year 100,000 people spend their holidays in Rostock. They've learnt a lot about the working and living conditions in the GDR.
It's beautiful here. I'd like to know how much rent they pay for a flat in these buildings.
Let's ask Frau Schumann.
Here you are.
Oh, thanks very much. Frau Schumann, Have you got a flat in a new building?
Yes, I have. 5 minutes from here. 3 rooms, a kitchen and a bathroom. Let's have a cup of coffee there this afternoon.
Mm-hmm. Fine, thanks. How much rent do you pay?
We pay 90 marks a month.
That isn't much. How long have you had your flat?
We've had it for 5 years. I think it's time to go to the swimming pool now.
Yes, let's go.
Let's have a look at some new words. Say after me, please. A visit to Rostock. Ships in the port. Mike and Dan have learnt a lot in Rostock. How long have they been there? Wie lange sind sie schon dort? How long have they been there? Anstelle des Präsens im Deutschen verwenden wir im Englischen das Present Perfect auch dann, wenn wir mit how long nach der bisherigen Dauer fragen und darauf antworten. Say after me, how long have they been there? They've been there for 2 days. They've been there since Thursday. Answer some questions now. How long have they been at the Neptune Hotel? They've been there for 2 days. How long have they been in the port? They've been there for an hour. How long has the ship been in the port? It has been there since yesterday. How long has this ship been there? It has been there since 1968. Anne asked Frau Schumann, how long have you had a flat? Wie lange haben Sie schon eine Wohnung? She answered, I've had a flat for 5 years. Ich habe seit 5 Jahren eine Wohnung. Beachtet das Present Perfect von have. Have had. Say after me, how long have you had a flat? I've had a flat for 5 years. Wir zeigen euch jetzt einige Gegenstände. Ihr sollt sagen, wie lange bzw. seit wann ihr sie besitzt. Zunächst ein Beispiel. Ihr sollt sagen, I've had the case for a year. Now you please. I've had the watch for 2 months. I've had the camera since Christmas. I've had the tent since my birthday. I've had the record for a long time. Thank you, girls and boys. Now let's see where Mike and Dan are and what they are doing. They are at a swimming pool, not to go swimming, but to watch a contest. A contest between two Rostock schools. Einen Wettkampf zwischen zwei Rostocker Schulen. A swimming contest between two Rostock schools.
That boy is good.
Yes, he's a very good swimmer.
Hmm. Do you think he'll win?
Yes. He'll win. I'd like to talk to one of the boys or girls. Can you help me, Frau Schumann?
All right. Let's see what we can do.
He's not bad.
No, he isn't. This is Carsten Krüger.
Guten Tag.
Good afternoon.
Do you speak English?
Yes, I do. But my English isn't very good. I've only had English lessons for 2 years.
At school?
Yes, at school.
My name is Mike Webster. This is Anne Collins.
Hello.
I'm a reporter. Can I ask you some questions?
Yes, of course. This is my first interview.
How old are you, Carsten?
I'm 15.
What's the name of your school?
I go to Herder Oberschule.
You're a good swimmer.
Where do you get your training? At school?
Not only at school. I go training every Monday and Thursday evening. I've got a very good trainer at our sports club.
What does your father do?
He's a worker at the Warnowwehr. He builds ships.
I see. Does your mother also go out to work?
Yes, she does. She's a shop assistant.
Is swimming your only sport?
No, I also play football and table tennis.
And your classmates?
They play football, handball, volleyball, basketball, table tennis.
I see.
Mike is asking Carsten about sports. Let's have a look at some new words. Say after me, please. A swimming contest. They play football. They play handball. They play volleyball. They play basketball. They play table tennis. Now you say what you play. First, an example. Do you play basketball? No, I play handball. Now you please. Do you play football? No, I play table tennis. Do you play basketball? No, I play football. Do you play volleyball? No, I play handball. Do you play handball? No, I play basketball. Let's go back to the swimming pool. It's the 100 meters freestyle now. Die 100 Meter Freistil stehen jetzt auf dem Programm. It's the 100 meters freestyle.
It's the 100 meters freestyle now. There's Carsten.
Mm-hmm, I see.
Do you think he'll win?
I don't know. Let's watch.
Carsten! Come on! He's going to win!
Come on!